Gotcha! Sorry, but that was too good. Oh, you don't know how much I miss jokes. Hilarity. Am I pronouncing that right? Some words I haven't said in a while. You've just arrived, and perhaps you're tired or hungry or reflective and want to sleep and eat and journal, which you should do, of course. But first, oh, what joy to talk with another creature. It's been so long. You must tell me everything about you. There's so much to say, so much to do. Oh, look at me. I'm going on, and you haven't seen. I mean, have you seen? What am I saying? Of course you haven't. So just, I will just follow me. That's what I said. You know, when I started talking again. Fernflare, you used to love to laugh at everything. And Brainshine, you sung the most beautiful harmonies. Don't you miss it?
Can you hear me? Who are you? I can't see you, but I know you're there. Yeah, you can definitely hear me. You've been watching for a while now, right? I guess I should introduce myself or something. My name is... Actually, that's stupid. You obviously already know my name. Sorry. Anyway, I'm guessing if you were able to put a stop to this, you would have done it by now. I mean, I know you're not, like, evil or anything, because you've already helped me so much. I really should thank you for that, for everything you've done. You're really like a friend to me, so thank you so much. I think more than anything else, I really don't want it all to be for nothing. Everyone else is dead. Maybe you already know that. I'm sure you do, actually, but it doesn't have to be that way, right? Well, there's a lot of stuff I don't understand. I don't even know if it's possible for me to understand it, but I know that this isn't my only story.
Okay, prepare yourself. 3D without glasses. What I want you to do is just focus on my eyes until your vision adjusts. Now, it takes a little time, and you might need to get a little closer to the screen.
I thought I was a hardcore horror movie fan, but I was living a lie!
Tell me, is it wrong for a punk rock chick who lives in a haunted, malevolent mansion to be touched by the magical friendship of a pony?
Oh, he definitely wasn't there. Oh, and more importantly, why would I get involved in something like that? No way! I swear it wasn't me! That's right! Actually, no. Because, well, I got so scared thanks to those creepy videos. I wasn't really thinking, I just asked her to stay over. Which means, we have airtight alibis. Oh yeah, that's true! One other person did come to the dining hall while we were there. Oh, as a matter of fact, I do have one question. You don't gotta sound so disappointed. Oh yeah. Okay, so, well... Oh man! I've totally seen people do that on detective shows. When you write, it can leave an imprint. Sketch over the next sheet of paper, and you can see the words. When I saw that, I was like, holy crap! I better make sure I rip the paper out before I use it from now on.
What did you do?
Okay, well, I'm making a summoning potion, but we're out of troll sap. I need to eliminate certain scum from my life forever! So I'm summoning a demon. You know, Edgar, stealing is wrong.
Yeah, so is creating demons for murder.
Yeah, I know. No thumbs up. I didn't want to summon these nerds. I wanted this guy. Fine. I wish I could get troll fat. I hate those guys. I should work on how I word my wishes. But whatever. Too bad the summoning potion doesn't need pudgy, thiefy kitty fat. Down the hall, second door on the right. No.
You? The spirit cookie who travels with snow? No, not at all. I was just waiting for nightfall. It is my favorite time of the day. What brings you here? I do not know. I have abandoned my duties as a guardian long ago. Besides, the sea is vast and deep. There are areas that I cannot see. But now that you mention it, I have noticed currents of life energy shifted towards a place across the sea. Somewhere northeast of Earthbread. But I do not know the exact destination. What I do know is that it is beyond my reach. I am sorry I was not of much help. Perhaps the Divine Tree can give an answer.
You've heard of my ship, the Crux and its crew? If you too love adventure, then join me. I've got your back. Yo, good morning. I'm about to head off. Coming with me? Let's get Xiangling to whip us up something for lunch. Believe me, a hot meal from her is far better than the salted fish we eat out at sea. Alright, I'm off for a drink. No one willing to sell you a proper drink, huh? Perhaps I can. Time moves quickly. Go. May the wind be at your back. If you ever want to trade tactics, I'm always ready. Hey, it's just a little lightning. No need to fear it on the open ocean, so there's even less need to fear it on dry land. I'm the captain, so you can be my first mate, deal? Such names are too outdated for you, huh? We'll call each other whatever you wish, then. I tend to be a good judge of character. When you've learned to read the open ocean, reading people is a cinch. And that's how I knew you're the good sort the second I laid eyes on you. It gives me great pride to be able to say that.
I knew this was impossible from the start. Hey, why are you training? I don't think a detective needs to do this. Do you look up to that idiot? I never realized until now how gross it is to hear men talk about being manly.
Hey! You're the one who's screwing around! Do you want to die?
She probably felt better after letting it all out, don't you think?
Then you should train too.
Me? What about me? What blood type do I like? Don't you mean, what's my blood type? Am I like a guinea pig to you guys?
You won't find a place quite like this kingdom anywhere on Earth. I know a place you'd love to visit. I can bring you to any place you want. Come visit again. Promise? Please? I come from beautiful tropical islands. This sky is just as full of stars as ours. With me around, even familiar places will feel like new. Oh, are you lost? Don't worry, just follow me. Try not to startle the local wildlife.
And that makes 16. I'm talking about us. There are 16 of us, all high schoolers. What do you think that means? Hey there. Guess I don't have to introduce myself, huh? I get that this is probably pretty confusing seeing yourself like this. The reason you don't remember recording this is because that memory was erased. I won the right to a special perk for participating in the killing game. Part of that perk is this video message. Also, you can't share this with anyone. There's another part to this perk. Something you get at the start of the game. I bet you know what I'm talking about. Something you've had from the start? Yeah? Now, I thought that if you were smart, you'd have used it to end the killing game. That obviously didn't work out. Life's never easy, huh? Well, anyway, that's the perk.
But I left you with one of my boys! That was awesome! I can't believe you came back to... Oh, no! Oh, my precious possession! Yep, check, noted. I might have taken too much in! I did it! I shut everything out, except the thing I needed to focus on! I also summoned monster trees with my stress, so should I see a doctor?
What, me? No, I'm fine. I just need to close my eyes for a couple of seconds.
No! I got distracted! That's it! No more distractions!
Yeah, I just thought you were doing that stuff for me. But upon reflection, yep, that doesn't make much sense.
You know what? I need to, I'll see you later. Spider demon? Come on, no, ew, yuck, I hate spiders, hate.
Is it noticeable?
No, man, it's all good. I definitely don't want to ride. It's totally fine.
Hello, nice to meet you. Yeah, so it seems most likely that the killer must have taken her by surprise. A struggle? Between who and who? So you're saying, sorry, but what if they did work together? And they just didn't know about the rule. Okay, so then, who did take the knife? We're not allowed to sleep anywhere but the dorms, but it doesn't say we have to stay in our assigned room, so I don't think that's a problem. So, the culprit removed some evidence? Oh yeah, true. But what does it mean? So the killer would have to be someone who didn't know they'd switched rooms? But what happens if we can't decide on who we think did it? Then, maybe someone picked the lock? Huh? What makes you say that? I see. So if someone read that note, but why would she switch them in the first place? Is that gold? But then the culprit took that from her too. Something sharp. You mean, like the kitchen knife? That was the only sharp thing found at the scene. No, that's not... How would you use it? Could someone really do that? Only the boys got toolkits, so the killer naturally assumed there wouldn't be one in there.
What, so you're both too busy to be my parents? You guys are the ones whose divorce keeps messing everything up, not me! This isn't fair! Good at what? Good at being divorced? What schedule? It's two of you and one kid! It's not that hard! Fine. Whatever, I can't go.
Yeah. Why wouldn't I be?
You're not.
Are you getting divorced? But then you're gonna get divorced after that. I remember how scared I was, how alone I felt.
I understand perfectly! Things were fine, but then you decided to change everything! Why are you doing this? Look around you. This isn't helping. Is that what you think? That it's your fault? It's not your fault the car is this way. There isn't a fault. It just is. But all this, you trying to make it your responsibility, this is causing real harm. Don't you see? I know what it's like to think that if you had just been better, things would have been different. That you're responsible for fixing things that are beyond your control. Just know that I speak from experience when I say, this is not your fault.